In this session, we are going to see an overview of the warehouse structure in EWVM. As we are going to see, it's very similar to the one used in WM, but there are a few differences. So first of all, we are going to see the whole structure. The same as with WM, it is going to be connected to the inventory management functionality. So if, for instance, we have a plant or a distribution center, this plant and distribution center can have different store locations. This is IM, inventory management functionality of SAP. And in the part of SAP EWM, we can connect some of these store locations to what are called warehouse numbers. This is the same meaning and the same structure as in SAP WM. As we see, we can link one store location or more than one. We could link, for instance, in this case, the other store location to another warehouse number, even to store locations of different plants can be linked to the same warehouse number, so they are managed in the same database. So below the warehouse number, we are going to have the different storage types. These are different areas inside this plant, for instance. For instance, we can have an area of racks, we can have an area of vessels. This depends a lot in the business, in how we can and how we want to model our warehouse, so we can define different storage types. Sometimes they are defined and based on the location where they are. Sometimes they can be defined based on the products or materials that they are going to hold. For instance, we can have a storage type for finished good, or we can have a storage type for raw materials, etc. So below the storage types, we can have different bins. In fact, we can have storage sections, as we are going to see now. And below storage sections, we are going to have the different bins. So these bins are going to be specific for each storage type. And then below each bin, we are going to have quants. We can have a storage bin with only one quant, or we could have more than one quant in the same bin. Depending on how we set up the system, we can allow this. We are going to see what a quant is in next sections. So we can have different quants, and sometimes one, sometimes more than one, even more than two. And then we have the sections. We can have different sections in the same storage type, and each section is going to group together different bins with their quants. And this is something new in EWM. We also can have what they are called activity areas, and these activity areas can group different bins, even, and this is a big difference, even bins of different storage types. So this could be the whole structure we can have. Depending on the business, it can be more complex or not. We're going to see now the different objects or the different organizational units of this structure. The first of all, in EWM, as we saw it, is the warehouse number. So the warehouse number is the highest level organizational unit in EWM. Normally it corresponds to a physical building, or if some physical buildings are close together, we can use the same warehouse number for managing them. So we can have as many warehouse numbers for an organization as different buildings or different group of buildings we want to manage. Storage types. This, as we saw, these are the different areas inside the warehouse number where we can store materials, and they group these materials based on the location in our warehouse, or based on some characteristics, some main characteristics. So we can have a warehouse number, for instance 001, and here we can have a storage type for high rack, a storage type for low racks, and a storage type for semi-finished goods, another one for finished goods. This depends a lot in the business and how we want to model the warehouse. Storage sections, as we saw it, they are going to subdivide storage types, and this can be for different reasons. For instance, fast-moving items, group items with similar handling requirements, depends a lot in the business. They might have, depending on the business, we might have different requirements, so we might decide to use different storage sections, or we might decide using storage sections based on a different concept. So if we have a warehouse number where we have storage types, for each of these storage types, we can have one or more storage sections. And finally, storage bins. This is the exact location where a material is placed. It's the lowest level, so we are not going to be able to identify a material inside a storage bin. This is the lowest level at which we are going to have the information in the system of where it is located, one material. It can be created in the user menu or in customizing. The rest of the organizational units we have seen so far are all created and managed in customizing. But the storage bin can be also created or managed in the user menu, so the users themselves can manage them. So if we have a storage type, we can have different storage bins. And they are always created within a storage type. They always belong to a storage type. Identified by unique coordinates. This means that depending on the code of these storage bins, we should be able to identify where it is located, this bin, and therefore the materials that are inside of it.